If the Japanese want to keep their export sales up, they'd better look out for Korea. At the moment, they're not much more than a small cloud on the horizon, but only 2 years ago, their motor industry was practically non-existent. George Turnbull, once managing director of British Leyland, was given £50 million to put them in the world's small car stakes. And the result? The Hyundai Pony was at the Geneva Motor Show, and shortly afterwards, we talked exclusively to George Turnbull on his way through London. Tony Bastable asked him, why couldn't we copy Korea and set up overnight new production lines with new cars?
Well, I don't think you'd really tackle it in quite the same way. I think the all the big manufacturers you see have very much bigger selling networks, very much bigger markets, and therefore they've got to plan on a much larger scale. In Korea, of course, we have a much smaller market and one which is developing, and therefore as a first stage it's possible to plan with that kind of volume in mind. You know, 100,000 a year was the type of, the volume that I thought we could be competitive at. Anything less than that I thought wasn't worth doing. So we planned for 100,000, and we can at Hyundai get to the 100,000 with about another $20 million spent on the plant and the buildings.
Now, this car you're making, is it really for the Korean domestic market or is it for export?
It was designed really for world markets. And we had it styled in Italy by Giugiaro, who is a world-famous stylist, as you know. He did a marvellous job on it. We were very pleased. So I think you could say that it's all been done with export in mind, but obviously it will take time to develop.
Right, so you had the money and you had you and a green field. Yes. Why did you decide to produce a car like the Pony?
Well, because it's the kind of car which that has an instant appeal, and it's a highly competitive type of car. There was no point in trying to produce a Rolls-Royce there because no one would buy it. I think with any new company starting, you must produce an economy type car which people feel they're going to get good value for money, and then you build your reputation on that, and then maybe afterwards you move up the scale. That's the way I think any new country would tackle making motor cars if they were going to sell them overseas.
That's the point I'm trying to make. You said it was competitive. It's in fact competitive with everybody else's small
models. Yes, it's the same kind of package. Yes, that's right. Yes.
How would you describe the characteristics of it? I mean, you described it as an economy car, but it clearly isn't a sort of miniature Jeep, is it? Which is
No. It's no. When I say economy, I mean it suits the pocket of the vast majority of the market. That's all I mean by that. But it's a very attractive car. It's very nicely styled. Got good instruments, good seating, got nice performance, handles well. In fact, it's got all the attributes that you would expect if you're going to be a first-time buyer of a nice-looking car. It's a 4-5-seater, but of course it's right in the competitive belt, you know, with all the other economy-type compacts-type cars.
Mm. Well, I'd expect you to do a decent sales pitch. It is, after all, your car. But reactions to it from Geneva were small, unsophisticated, underdamped, cramped, noisy. And yet your company president expects the car to make South Korea's motor industry in Asia second only to Japan in the short term, and I'm no doubt bigger than Japan's in the long term. Mm. How are you really going to achieve it with a car like the Pony?
Well, I don't see why not. I think Hyundai have got a long way to go before they can really take the big Japanese companies on. But my guess is that by the 1980s, the Hyundai Motor Company will be a very big motor company and a true competitor in world terms.
The car you saw there is the very first Hyundai Pony to reach Britain, but they won't generally be available here until 1979.